COVID-19 herd immunity is more complex than getting 70% vaccine rate, expert says. Many experts still hope that we can achieve herd immunity against COVID-19. Once reached, the transmission in communities will likely drop. However, just reaching the desired threshold isn't as easy as 1, 2, 3. It is more complicated, according to an epidemiologist. But before we continue, please like this video if you find this informative and subscribe to our channel for more interesting and informative content. Don't forget to click the bell icon too to get the latest updates. In Oregon, USA, the vaccination rate has peaked at 73% that slashed COVID cases throughout the state. So many are wondering when they can stop wearing face masks. But experts say that it's too early to tell. After all, not everyone has been vaccinated and no one is sure when another deadly variant may emerge. That 73% vaccination rate seems like a dream come true because the expected herd immunity threshold for COVID-19 is at 70%. Shouldn't the figure justify it? Not at present. Epidemiologist and Oregon State Health Officer Dr. Dean Seidlinger said, "While we can feel really good about the numbers having come down, they're not where any of us would like to be in terms of the level of severe disease and even the level of folks who are getting sick." One key player why herd immunity is complicated is the Delta variant. It spreads so easily than the other known variants. Even those who have been fully vaccinated may still contract COVID if they ease on safety measures. Perhaps, if Delta didn't emerge, herd immunity is considered already here. Another player is the behavior of COVID-19 and influenza this winter season. Every year, it is a season where most people mingle to celebrate the festivities. Mingling usually means being physically close to loved ones, which gives the best opportunity for infectious diseases. What may help us simplify the situation is the booster shot. Although the original series remains effective, getting a booster is recommended, especially for those more prone to COVID-19. Dr. Seidlinger recommends even fully vaccinated people practice preventive measures to protect vulnerable groups. The state of Oregon confirmed that boosters are advised 6 months after receiving the second dose of either Pfizer or Moderna vaccine. For Johnson & Johnson vaccine, boosters are good 2 months after the first dose. Do you agree with the expert? Do you still believe we can achieve herd immunity? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.